Hi everyone, I am Dr. Gautami, MD in orthodontics, and in today's video, we are going to learn something about biomechanics. So what do you mean by biomechanics? As the word biomechanic itself tells you that it is nothing but mechanics used in the oral musculature or in the oral environment in a biological manner of way. So the word biomechanics is derived from bio plus mechanics. So the mechanics which have been used in the biological environment is what called as biological mechanics. So, in biomechanics, what we have to know is the basic physics. The basic physics are like the Newton's law, your force. These are the basic terminologies which I will be using in today's video. So, the basic physical mechanics, when implemented in an oral cavity under a biological environment, what are the effects we see is what we are going to see. Biomechanics is one of the most crucial part of your orthodontics, which will decide of how to move a teeth. So all of you would have been aware of the biology of tooth movement, right? So now you just know the biology of the tooth movement, but you also should know how is this biology related with the mechanics and what makes this tooth to move in a mechanical platform. So let us come to a few of these terminologies called as center of resistance. Center of resistance is nothing but any object, not only a tooth, but even if you take this pen, it has a center of resistance. A mass, a center mass is present for any object. Provided if the object is under the gravity, you call it as center of gravity. In case there is no gravity and the object is in the air, then it is called center of the mass. So each and every object, not necessarily a tooth, a block, a pen, a book, anything can have a center of mass when kept in the equilibrium. So whatever is the load of this object lies at the center of this pen or lies at the center of the object, which is called as center of resistance. The terminologies are center of mass and center of gravity. So if you can consider any object in the universe having a center of mass or a gravity. Now, when I consider a tooth, every tooth has its center of resistance, which is located in the middle of the root part. So, the center of resistance of a tooth also depends on the bone. For example, let us take a central incisor which has the center of resistance here and this is surrounded by the bone. Right? But what happens when there is a change in the bone? For example, even in this picture. If you can see, the center of resistance varies with the root length and the alveolar crest height, that is the bone. So as the bone moves more apical, the center of resistance also moves more apical. With a healthy bone, the center of resistance is at the middle two-thirds of your root towards the apical portion and the coronal portion. So what is single point of force? As I always mention, let us discuss a few terminologies now. Now we have discussed center of resistance. Now the second one is force. mass, equilibrium, and couple. So center of resistance is nothing but the concentration of an object which is towards a mass of a subject is called as your center of resistance. Force is nothing but whatever is the object. When I want to move an object from one point to another point, you apply some amount of force, right? So the mass of the object into the acceleration is called as your force. F is equal to mass into acceleration. So what is this acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but the rate of the magnitude. For example, there is a pen here and I am applying some amount of force to move this. So this acceleration from one point to the other point, when this object is getting displaced, this is called as your acceleration. So the magnitude, that is the rate of acceleration, is your called as your magnitude. So is mass dependent with the force? Definitely yes. Imagine this pen is 10 grams and I have another object which is 50 grams. So when I want to push this pen with another pen which is 50 grams, definitely it is not possible. So, but if I use the very same pen to use another pen, definitely it is possible because it has high amount of mass when compared to this pen. So what is single point of force? Any object to be moved. So what is Newton's third law? Any act, one action has an equal and opposite reaction. So when I want to put a force on this object, a single point of force, it will try to move. So consider this first picture of your molar, which has an occlusal aspect, and consider a point of a molar which is from the frontal aspect, and a central incisor. So what is this? This is the center of mass. And these are the center of resistance. So for a central incisor, the center of resistance is at the middle third of the root. And for a molar, the center of resistance is right below the furcation area of the roots. And when you see occlusally, this is the center of resistance area. Now, I have applied some amount of X amount of force. So where have I applied the force? I have applied the force right at the center of resistance. So when I apply the force at a center of resistance, the body moves bodily. That means there is a translation happening here. But the same picture, I apply force here. The same amount of X force here. What happens? Does it move bodily? Definitely no. It will have a tipping motion. That is why, because it is away from the center of resistance. So whatever is the distance from the center of resistance to this picture is what your magnitude. Similar way for a molar also. For a molar, you need extra force, that is 2x or x square. Whereas the same bodily movement, if you want, the force should be applied at the center of resistance. If you apply the force at the bracket level, this amount of tooth movement will not be seen. So when you apply at a single point of force at one point, when you apply a force at one single point targeting, that is called as your single point force. So here is a picture. As I told you, I have applied a single point of force at the bracket here. So if you can see, there is only a tipping motion. Whereas I have applied the forces, that is intrusive force here. Here also there is again a tipping motion. But whereas here I have applied the force, you know, at the center of resistance. So that is why you have a bodily movement here. Right? In case I apply a force at the center of resistance and also at the bracket, still it will not give a center of resistance force. That is, you will not get a bodily movement, but again, you will be getting a tipping movement. So this is the single point of force. I hope you understood the basic terminology of center of resistance, single point of force, and what is the force. What is a moment? If the line of action of a force is at a distance from the center of resistance, the force will produce some rotation. So, the potential for rotation is measured as a moment. So, here we have a picture. Imagine this tooth and this is the center of resistance, right? So, when you apply some amount of force here, that is, for example, X amount of force. So, here I have applied some force. And what is the center of resistance? What is the distance between the center of resistance? For example, let us take it is 8 millimeters. So, an 8 millimeter distance, and let us assume the force applied here is 10 grams. So, how is the moment calculated here? The moment is calculated by the amount of force into the distance. So, the force is 10 grams into 8 mm. So, the moment is 80 grams per millimeter. So, you require, in order for this tooth to move or rotate in a particular direction, you need 80 grams of, you know, moment. It is not the force. It is only the 10 grams of force, but you need 80 grams of your moment to happen this rotation. For example, same thing, it is not 10 grams. I am applying here 200 grams of force with 8 mm of the distance. What will happen here? There will be a complete rotation because when I've increased the double or when I've increased the force, definitely there will be an increase in the moment. Force is directly proportional to the moment and distance. So this is called as a moment. So moment is nothing but the tendency to move or to be moved is called as your moment. So how is the moment defined or how is the moment used? Here it depends on the direction of the magnitude, clockwise, which can be clockwise or counterclockwise. If you see here, this is the line of force, right? And this is the center of resistance and the distance between the center of resistance to the line of force. But similar force, I have applied it like this. So what is happening here? There is a clockwise rotation happening. But I have now given a force from here. So what will happen? There is again a clockwise motion happening. But here, the force is only given clockwise. So what will happen? Definitely there is an anti-clockwise kind of moment happening here. So the moment is also dependent on the direction of line of force, which will determine whether it is clockwise or counterclockwise. So now what is the moment of force for different types of orders? So if you can see here, this is the molar. So what is, before I go ahead with this, you need to know what is a first order, second order and a third order bends. So basically these are the different types of bends which you give in your edgewise appliance. For example, you have started the treatment where you have done alignment and then you have done retraction and also finishing has been done. But slight amount of finishing has to be still left. So if you want an in and out bend, means imagine this is the arch, central incisor, lateral, canine, premolar, molars. And you want this premolar to move out or you want to move it in. So whenever you want to bring an in and out changes, it is called as your first order bends. In order you want to bring a mesiodistal, for example, you have your imagine this is your lower central incisors. So if you see here, I want to bring this more towards the mesial side. So any mesiodistal tipping is called as your second order bends. Coming to the third order bends, third order is something to do with your torque. So what is torque? Now I have, this is the bracket. Example, this is the bracket. Now I want this tooth to be, the inclination has to change. I'm very sure you are aware of what is an inclination. So if imagine this is the tooth and I apply some amount of force here. Right. So when I apply the force here, it is shifting. The coronal part is going inside and the root is coming outwards. So this is called as your torque, that is labiolingual. Labiolingual movement of any tooth is called as your third order bend. So when you want a change in the labiolingual section, it is called as your third order. And what is this moment of force related to all these? So for example, the amount of force you have applied here is 10 grams, and the direction of the way it is moving, for example, this distance whatever is there, imagine this as 10 millimeters. So it is giving at least 100 milligrams of force for per millimeter. So this is the moment of force for a third order bend. But whereas for a second order bend, the moment of force ratio is comparatively less when compared to your first order bend. And coming to the third order, it is completely normal to have that whatever is the distance between the line of force of action and the moment to force ratio. So moment to force is nothing but when you apply some amount of force, whatever degree of rotation or displacement happening, according to the distance from the center of resistance to the force applied, is what called as your moment to force ratio.